Chlorine Industrial Production by Sergio Cano, Sergio Conde, Adrián Cotobal, Daniel del Rosal, Guillermo García Cabañas, and David Fernández. Index, Design and Development of Chemical Processes and Equipment. Fundamental and Applied Research from the Molecular Level to Full Industrial Scale. Plant Operation and Management. Optimization and control of industrial operations. Environmental management, monitoring and pollution control.
As you could see in the title, in this presentation we will be speaking about the production of chlorine. Chlorine ranks number 7 on the list of the most commonly produced chemical substances. In elemental state, it forms diatomic molecules, but in nature, it is always combined with other elements, due to its high radioactivity, especially appearing as a halide in seawater. As it is a strong oxidation agent, chlorine must be prepared by electrolysis and not by chemical oxidation. By far the largest part, about 95% of the chlorine product globally, is obtained via the chloralkali process. This method is based on the electrolysis of brine, a concentrated aqueous solution of sodium chloride. The stoichiometric equation for this process is the one we can see in the slide. When the solution is introduced in the cell, a redox reaction occurs when an electric current passes through the electrodes. In the anode, chlorine ions yield an electron and are transformed into diatonic chlorine. At the cathode, the electron from the chlorine ion is taken by protons, H+, which results in the formation of diatomic hydrogen molecules. After this reaction, sodium plus is dissolved in water with OH- ions, forming sodium hydroxide. Here we can see the chemical reactions occurring. As we can see, this reaction produces three useful subproducts: sodium hydroxide, chlorine gas, and hydrogen gas. However, these subproducts can also react with each other. For this reason, the cells are designed to separate molecular chlorine from the sodium hydroxide solution and molecular hydrogen, so side reactions can be avoided. These reactions consume the products to be obtained and are dangerous because the hydrogen gas and chlorine gas mixture is very explosive. After this process, the chlorine gas obtained is hot and humid, so it must be conditioned, dried, and compressed.
Fundamental and applied research from the molecular level to full industrial scale. Chlorine is rarely prepared in the laboratory due to the fact that it requires specific conditions in order to be stored. Nonetheless, to produce it, we can follow one of two different methods. These are the Scheele's method and the Scheele's modified method. Another way to produce chlorine in a laboratory involves using oxidants such as potassium permanganate. In this case, the reaction takes place in a cold medium and produces chlorine directly as a gas. We can find three main forms of producing chlorine when we talk about an industrial scale. The most important one, which occupies 95% of the production, is the chloralkali process. We can also produce chlorine from sodium chloride or chloridric acid. Finally, another way that has been used in industry to produce chlorine is by mixing air and chloridric acid in a tube that is heated to 400 Celsius degrees in the presence of a catalyst. This method is not used currently because the reaction is reversible and not too efficient.
We can find three different types of cells for the electrolysis of chlorine.
In the mercury cell plants, a solution of sodium chloride is used as the electrolyte, what is called as brine. The anode is made of graphite and the cathode is made of mercury. We can see in the slides the equations that are followed in the cell. We can see that sodium reduces and chlorine oxidates. The resultant products are chlorine but also hydrogen, as we can see in the photo of the right. The resultant chlorine then escapes the cell as a gas and is collected as a byproduct in what is called the Kastner-Kellner process. Diaphragm cells slowly replaced mercury cells until in the year 2000, the polymer-modified asbestos diaphragm was the most common diaphragm cell. However, it still contains a minimum of 75% of chrysotile asbestos, the most commonly encountered form of this material, mixed with PTFE fibers, a strong chemically resistant plastic. For all of these reasons, personnel exposed to asbestos should be provided with individual protection, equipment, and personal health check program. In the past, mercury and diaphragm cells have been very popular. However, they have been proven to be the most environmentally unfriendly because of the use of asbestos and mercury. The membrane cell process is a superior method in its energy efficiency and lack of harmful chemicals. This kind of cell is based on a container that is divided in two parts by a membrane, as we can see in the photograph of the right. This membrane is the most important part of the cell and acts as a cation exchanger. In this invention, a solution of brine is circulated in the anode semi-half and water is passed in the cathode one, as we can see in the equations from the left. Then, brine dissociates because of the oxidation of chlorine. In the cation semi-half, on the other hand, water dissociates, forming hydroxide ion and hydrogen. The sodium cations follow two paths. One of them abandons the cell as a byproduct, and the other part crosses the membrane that acts as a cation exchanger to react and form caustic soda. Then, gaseous chlorine and hydrogen abandon the cell from each of its parts and are collected afterwards.
For the process to be as efficient as possible, the brine must be free of impurities. These impurities are known as hardness and can be found as calcium, magnesium, or other elements present in the reaction. Anyway, they shorten the performance and lifetime of the membranes and can even damage the electrodes. Partial membrane blockage leads to increased electrical operational costs and additional losses because of the need of replacing the membranes. The increasing of hardness levels can mean a reduction of the efficiency of a 1 or a 2%. The process variation can be reduced by monitoring the samples constantly. Trend charts with automatic warning limits saves cost from product loss or reduced product quality, whereas manual sampling and laboratory analysis techniques may take several hours to accomplish the same results.
Environmental management, monitoring, and pollution control. Chlorine residual control. This method of operation relies on the dynamical modulation of chlorine feed rate to maintain the residual within a desired band of operation. For this matter, a chlorine residual analyzer is used to monitor the residual and, in case of disadjustment, it initiates a corrective signal to the chlorine feeder. Chlorine residual occurs in wastewater in several forms: monochloramine, dichloramine, and free chlorine. Due to the amount of ammonia in wastewater, the residual generally takes the form of monochloramine or dichloramine. Chlorine residual control measurements are accomplished in plants generally using one of four methods. Iodometric. This method uses a standard sodium thiosulfate solution to titrate the iodine liberated by the chlorine from potassium iodide. Starch, which is used as an indicator, gives a blue color with iodine. To ensure measurement of chloramines, the titration is performed in an acidic solution. The method measures total residual chlorine. Diethylphenylene, DPD, tetrametric. This method is a colorimetric used for wastewaters that do not contain iodine-reducing substances. The basic method can be modified to measure monochloramine, dichloramine, and free chlorine. Oxidation reduction potential meter, ORP. Another means of monitoring chlorine is ORP. The ORP instrument monitors water for its oxidation potential. Since chlorine is an oxidant, the measurement of the oxidation potential is therefore related to the chlorine residual in the water.
Just to conclude, we've discussed about the production of chlorine, but we would like to tell you about some of the applications of chlorine. Chlorine is widely used in industry as a bleaching agent for papers and textiles. Ordinary bleach used at home contains the active ingredient sodium hypochlorite, approximately 5% by mass, which is prepared by the reaction of chlorine gas with the cold solution of sodium hydroxide. Chlorine is also used to purify water and disinfect swimming pools. When the chlorine dissolves in water, it yields hydrochloric acid and hypochlorous acid. It is believed that hypochlorite ions destroy bacteria by oxidation of compounds that are vital to them. Chlorinated methanes, such as carbon tetrachloride and chloroform, are useful as organic solvents. Large amounts of chlorine are used to produce insecticides, such as DDT, dichlorodiphenyl-3-chloroethane. However, due to the damage they cause to the environment, the use of many of these compounds is completely forbidden in some countries, such as the United States. Chlorine is also used to produce polymers, like the famous polyvinyl chloride.